Hi guys, thank you very much for being on this page. I'm just waiting for some people to join in. So let some comments appear. I'm already here.
जी, चाय के साथ कुछ और लाना है।
So there are two people already there, Abhishek Gandhi. So thank you, Abhishek, for being here. Divya Hazari, a top fan, thank you. Hi, hello. Namaste, yes, very much namaste. I'm just waiting for a couple of more people to come online. Yes, Mrinmayee, finally I am there on your page. Preeti, hi. Vanita, Nisha, Belani, Ambauni, hi. Okay, so if you all have any question, we can start off straight away with the question. Jyoti Dubey, hi. Divya, yes, I got that message. Hello, Vinita. Hi, Lakshmi. Okay, do you have any questions? So we can start off with the question straight away. Otherwise, I would like to tell you, moms, what you do with your children. Some of you must be having very small children, some of you must be having children who are of an understanding age. So how are you handling the children at home? Because in this kind of a scenario, to keep all the children locked up in the house, it must be quite a task. So my children are very old, so I don't have to bother about that. But young children, school-going children or college-going children also have some kind of an entertainment if they want to. But school-going children must be very difficult. Of course, but I've heard that you all are having online education for the children. You all have classes literally for school children, so that must be keeping them busy. So that's a nice thing to know, but it is really difficult for children to really keep themselves busy at this point in time. But what I suggest to you people is you have to. It is your duty, like the mother's duty, I feel, to now is the time to install and instill good values in your child, because the earth is changing, and there are a lot of changes which are going to take place on this planet. So the children need to understand that they have to finally, the final goal is for us to turn towards some kind of. Now, if you use words like meditation and all that, they will not enjoy. But if you make them listen to good kind of music, calming music, or or tell them some stories which are moral oriented. Like I remember when I was in school, there used to be a subject called moral science. But we do have Isapnitis and so many other stories. We can tell the children what is goodness, what is kindness. So this is a very good way of turning your children inwards and into spirituality and into meditation. I understand, wants to go. She, it's difficult to keep her home. This Apeksha says to keep her home all the time occupied. Yes, now make them do drawings, make them listen to good music. You do some kind of an activity, a meditational activity, which will be good for the children, which will help the children. Like, see, what happens is children are now loving this time because both the parents are there, which they rarely got the father. The mother was there, but they rarely got the father. So now that they are really enjoying having the mother and father at home. So make the best use. There are a lot of these children's magazines and a lot of these children's books. You read them good stories. So that's a very good way of engaging them to read them, make them read good stories, and to make them draw something which is creative. Some way or the other, you have to see to it that they do some good activity which will contribute to their soul, which will contribute to their life. That is very important for the yes, moral education. I agree with you, Poonam. Moral education is very important for your children, since you all are mothers. Most of you are mothers over here, mothers of all age group children. Panchatantra, yes, Apeksha, that's a very good one. Panchatantra to your daughter, you read daily. That's a very, very nice one, Panchatantra. So this is exactly what I'm saying. To keep children at home now and to keep them occupied, I understand, is very difficult. But this is the right time to give them good sanskar. Like, the conditioning of your child can be done now in this moment, in this time when we are all sitting at home. Yes, I do miss the moral science classes also, which is not there in schools nowadays, because they really taught something good to us. You know, they taught us how to be good human beings, how to show love to people, how to show kindness to people, which is there in us. It is just there in us, you know. So since nowadays children don't have those kind of agendas in school, you could do that at home. Like one of the mothers said, you can do this Panchatantra or nice fables. There are so many children's books and so many children's stories that these 3 months of lockout also will, I mean, you'll run out of them. You'll run out of the days to read them the stories. There are so many. Yes, Divya, when they leave the phones. But what I feel is you have to make a timetable for the children. Just the way a timetable is set in school, you'll have to make a timetable for the children. They have to have only so much time, screen time. This is your screen time. You decide the time, maybe after lunch or whatever, when they're sleepy, drowsy. This is your screen time, 1 hour, 2 hours, whatever, depending on the age of your child. And that much only screen time. And after that, the phone has to be kept away, means away. That much strictness one has to do. Teenagers also has to be dealt in the same way. Sheila Das is asking me about teenagers. They have to also dealt in the same way. You have to give them a time. Screen time is very important in and essential today, because they are going to feel very deprived. Today's children are not like the way we were brought up. There was no mobiles and laptops and all these things were not there. So we automatically were in the habit of just reading. Only when I went to college or something like that, I remember when television first happened. So we didn't have access to all these things. We used to play with our other children around, or school children, things like that. Somebody is asking me, Vinita is asking me how to help them do meditation. They will not enjoy the word meditation at all. Don't even use the word meditation to them. Meditation is not meant for teenagers or children below that, because they won't be interested in it. So you have to develop different words when you talk of God, meditation. Those words are not very interesting to the children at all. So don't say all these words, but teach them goodness. Goodness can be taught without using the words like, yes, Mahabharata, mythology, I agree with you. So use them words like this, like goodness. You have to be kind, you have to be good, you have to be helpful. You just serve someone without having any agenda in your mind. Just be good. These kind of things, they have to roll stories around that and talk about it. Mahabharata has got a lot of all these stories. I mean, I absolutely agree over here. So mythology interest, yes, that's true. So this is what I mean when I say that you all have to develop all these kind of ideas, and a mother can do that. You have to be strict where you have to be, and you have to be lenient where you have to be. Again, taking care of the children, they cannot go out in this kind of an scenario. Please protect them and let them stay at home. Again, you take care of their food habits. Yes, they like to listen to audible stories. That's also fine, as long as they're keeping their mind occupied in something good, something creative. They can, of course, do the audible stories. Absolutely, absolutely fine. But then after the audible story, you keep a questionnaire. You know, that way you can keep them busy. On mobile, yes, you can. You keep a questionnaire as to what have you learned from this story. Tell me some 2 good points of the story. Or whatever relating to the story, you can ask a questionnaire. So that keeps them occupied, and that makes their mind thinking about good things in life. So my kids love to watch Mahabharata, and trust the questioning skills I have increased. Yes, and yes, true. Mahabharata, if you also listen, you'll also learn a lot from Mahabharata. And at any age, Mahabharata is a kind of our holy book, which we can call it, the Bhagavad Gita. At any age you open that book, at any age you will still learn something new. At every age it teaches something different and different new. So those type of stories are there also. But there are these lot of children's books which I feel that I also enjoy reading them sometimes. They're very nice. So the questions are endless, I agree. So children are like that. They are. If you don't like them questioning, you will not like it also. You have to have your child's mind thinking, but thinking about good things and the right things. So food habits are important. Nowadays, thankfully, not all restaurants are open. So not thankfully, those pizzas and burgers are not so easily available. So I'm glad they can eat good ghar ka khana. How to remove negativity from the house? The very easy way of doing it is you have a salt water. When you do the pota, when you sweep the floor and you mop the floor, when you're mopping the floor, put some salt in the water. That's a very good way to keep your house from negativity. Another way I always tell them is to do the Om Prabhu Shanti Havan. It is there on my YouTube channel. Guys, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Go through those videos. You will learn so much from those videos. A huge, huge kind of a transformation will happen in those videos, through those videos. So check out the Chakra Dhyana, which you must do. Chakra Dhyana for beginners is the one which you please check it out, see, listen, and then follow it. The second one, as from negativity from the house, Om Prabhu Shanti Havan, which is also there on my YouTube. So at the moment you may not get the samagri which is required to do the havan. See the havan first fully, but whenever this opens up, please start doing the havan ASAP. That will help you also. Your inner self and your aura and everything else around you will change. The whole vibration changes with the havan. How to make them write? Because after a gap of 3 months, kids have become lazy to write. Any suggestion? Well, here there is no magic wand that I can tell you, okay, do this and they'll start writing. What you can do after you make the stories, after you make them listen to the stories, you give them a questionnaire and tell them write your answers. So let them write and in that way. What is my YouTube channel name? It is Smita Jaikar itself. And you will find a lot of these videos on Smita Jaikar, on Chakra and all that. So please subscribe for the channel and watch all those videos. Share the name of your channel. It is Smita Jaikar only. I have been following you, Sangeeta. Thank you very much for following me on the channel. Besides, I'm there on every platform, Facebook and Instagram and LinkedIn and Twitter. You can send me messages also on that if you can't understand something. And if you don't know something, if you want more clarification, you can always get in touch with me. Yes, what else? Riti Arora Agarwal, seen you after a long time. Yes, but with a new look, maybe you all are quite surprised to see me with this new look. To rest your minds, I would say that this was on my mind for the past 10 years to shave my head and donate it to the cancer society. But somehow I did not have the guts to do it. Or sometimes whenever I was to decide, some project used to come my way and I just say, okay, later, okay, later, okay, later. That was what was happening. But this time I just took it up. I said, no, now is the time and no more further delaying it. And so I just shaved off my head. You're looking beautiful, Mrinmayee. Thank you so much. You have to say that I'm looking beautiful. You can't say on this platform I'm not looking good. Oh, God. I'm very thankful to come on this platform, Neha. I brought a smile to your face. I'm glad you did that. Okay. So, what else? If you all want to know anything more, you all can ask me now on this platform, because when I don't have somebody to talk to, I don't know what to say after some time. I feel I'm just talking blankly to somebody just like that. So if you ask me some questions, it's easier to answer them. Let me have some water. So these are a few tips how you can handle your children. I have a small granddaughter who's 5-year-old and her mother keeps her busy so beautifully. It is amazing how my daughter-in-law keeps that child so beautifully occupied. There is a proper टाइम टेबल डन फॉर हर, दिस द टाइम शी विल गेट अप, दिस द टाइम शी विल डू दिस, दिस द टाइम शी विल डू दैट, एंड दैट गर्ल हैज ओबेड, शी इज 6 year old, बट शी ओबेज सो ब्यूटिफुली, शी डज एग्जैक्टली व्हाट अ मदर टेल्स हर टू डू. सो चिल्ड्रन हु आर स्मॉल, हु आर यंग, दे कैन बी मोल्डेड बाय द मदर. दिस इज द टाइम टू मोल्ड देम, टू मोल्ड देयर माइंड्स, टू मोल्ड द कंडीशनिंग हैज टू बी प्रॉपर एट दिस टाइम बिफोर दे आर 6 years old. After they're 6 years old, 7 years old, the I, the me starts developing, and then they start having a mind of their own. Then it becomes difficult to train them. So if you have children below the age of 6, you can train them now, and now is the time to train them, not later on. Don't even say ki, okay, let her grow up, let him grow up, and then I will train him, and then I'll teach him some good thing. It is not going to happen. You can, because the child's subconscious mind is at the highest till the age of 6. You can mold the child till the age of 5-6 years old, not beyond that. Whatever good values, whatever you want to inculcate, will only happen till they are 6-7 years old. After that, then you have to just, see how the child's mood is, see how the child's nature is, and then mold accordingly. So that becomes a more difficult task for a parent to do. So if your children are after 7 years old, then this is what will come in handy, is you reading stories to them, telling them good things, giving them a questionnaire, give marks to this questionnaire so that there's an incentive. Okay, I'll give you this if you answer this question right. Maybe I'll give you 5 minutes extra of screen time, which is a very attractive thing nowadays, to watch. They are constantly watching something or the other on the mobile. So this is how you lure them in these times, in this moment. Now there are some children by default, they are artistic. Some of them love to sing, some of them are learning music, some of them are learning dancing. So you can put on your mobile, you can put on the tanpura and the harmonium, the music, and then they can sing for you, and dancing they can do. If they love drawing, they can encourage them to draw something. So and if they are not interested in any of these things, if they're interested in reading, fine. But this is a time, if they're not interested in anything, which doesn't happen generally, unless you have not tapped the thing what the child really wants to do. You know your child best, you know what he's good at, you know what the interests are of the child. So develop and work around that now. Encourage, see what is the latent talent in the child now. This is the time to see what is the latent talent in your child. Most parents, if they are working parents, they don't have time to look after their children. Their both parents are out of the house, and you hardly spend time with your child to understand what exactly your child is going through, what does he want, what are his emotional wants. What is the requirement of his soul? You don't have time for all that. This is the time you have now. So spend that time with your child and try to find out and get more things out of that child. Become a friend to him and get a lot of things out of that child now. This is the time. So why am I addressing these children's thing now? Because you're all moms, and this is the page of the Uni Moms. So all over the world, I guess the moms are there, and they must be going through a tough time just now with the lockdown and the children and the family and everything. So play games with them, play some kind of a game with them. Then there is Pictionary. There is so many of those type of children's games which are there, on the mobiles and all nowadays. So you can play Pictionary. Little older, like college going children and all, you can encourage them to play Scrabble so that their vocabulary increases. So you'll have to find out ways and means of how to keep your child engaged. Besides, there are these mothers groups which are on WhatsApp. So your children's age, say from 11 to 17, they have a mothers group of 11 to 17. Share what the other mothers are doing with their children, so you'll get an idea of what's happening. So this is how you have to cultivate and think out of the box. This is the time to think out of the box as to what you can do and engage your children in a good way. In a good way. So that's all that I would like to tell you mothers to do. besides that, for yourselves, you all should do the chakra dhyana, which will keep a stability, which will keep your mind calm, and you will not get frustrated with the work at home and everything else. There are so many. There's no help nowadays for most people. So you get into an irritable mode and angry mode and things like that. You don't know what to do. So for y'all, I honestly and seriously suggest chakra meditation is the best meditation ever. Not because I like it, not because I take classes of it, but it is there in the Vedas and the Upanishads. And I know what it does. So start turning inwards. Start thinking of your own being, of your own self. The self, you are asittva, I would say. So chakra dhyana is a very, very good way to turn inwards. Now, of course, as I said, Om Prabhu Shanti Havan is another fantastic way, but you may not get all those things now, you may not have it. But if you do get it, please start right away to do that. Do some kind of a meditation, some breathing technique, something which will keep your mind calm. Let me tell you something. This is the time when the planet is shifting and transforming in a very different way, which nobody has been able to fathom. Not even the masters and all have been able to fathom what exactly is happening. So the planet is really going through some churning, some change. If we don't adjust with this change, if we don't align with Mother Nature just now and Mother Earth, align our magnetic field of our body and the magnetic field of the planet has to be aligned with each other. If it is not, we will, as human beings, those who are not willing to change and transform, will go through a lot of turmoil. We'll really go through a lot of turmoil adjusting. So be willing to change, be willing to transform. Yes, I understand. It's not just you and me. The whole world, remember, it's a pandemic. Whole world and every human being on this planet is going through something or the other. Every human being, whether you're rich, you're famous, you're poor, you're whoever, most important and most powerful human being on this earth, but each person is going through his own turmoil. So learn from this. If we don't change now, we are going to face a lot of turmoil in the future. So to avoid that turmoil, please, please start turning inwards. The only demand of this entire coronavirus is to turn inwards, to pray, to meditate. The divine has put us through this. It's only divine intervention which will get us out of this, because no one can see the virus. Nobody has been able to find the vaccine to it. It's been so many months, nothing is coming out of it. So only divine intervention is the only help that we have. So turn towards divinity is what I would like to say over here. So for all of us, including our children, including ourselves, we got to be absolutely aligned and go take each day as it comes. Don't think of the future. My job is not there. I don't know what I'll do in future. There's no money coming in. Don't think of the future. Just take each day as it comes. One who has put you through it one who has put you to it will take you through it. Please remember that. Jo chonch deta hai, wo chara bhi deta hai. You've heard of this many a times probably. So, the Mother Earth or Mother Nature or Divinity is not meant to give you trouble. Is not meant to harm you. You will get harmed on your own if you don't listen to her. If you don't align with her. So it is an outcome of your own stupidity that you will be doing. She is not harming you. Please remember that. Divine is not harming you. They are not punishable. The divine is not punishable. Mother Earth, Mother Nature is not punishable. They are not punishing at all. We get punished by our own ways of living and by own thought process. Just the way we are punished now. This is the outcome of what we have done to her. She is not taking her revenge on us. Please, if you are thinking that way. She is not taking revenge on us. Mother Earth is not taking revenge on us. This is the outcome of what we have done to her. So let us shift that and change that a little bit. If you understand this, you have to get this in your mind that we have to align. We all have to now virtually hold each other's hands and just take each other together upwards. So whoever your friends are, whoever is close to you, talk to good people, talk to nice things, listen to good things. Let some goodness come into your mind. Don't watch some rubbish television serials. Watch something which will contribute to you, not something which will disturb you. And please, for heaven's sake, stop watching the news. Stop encouraging all those stupid WhatsApp messages. They are just driving everybody crazy by those messages. Stop doing all those things which are disturbing you and bothering you. Do things which are contributing to you. You ask yourself, you ask your inner self. Now you will get the answers. You will get the answers now when you ask. Ask that divine, what is this? What am I supposed to do? How do I turn inwards? What do I do for meditation? What do I read now? Ask, keep asking questions to your divine inside you. And you will go through it. Even if your children are bothering you, ask the divine, okay, now what do I do with my child? You will get an idea. Either it will come as a thought, or if you're reading something, something will, you know, that will answer your question, or you're watching a live session like this, that answer will come through that, or something or the other, you will get an answer. Okay? So, I think I've spoken enough. Best readings and hearings for 14 months. What is that? That something. Ma'am, you like my new look. Thank you. Vaishu Bangera, thank you. Going bald is now in fashion. Oh, really? I didn't know that. I didn't do it out of fashion. How to channelize their energy, and they have been inside for a long, becomes difficult to keep them calm. Yes, I understand that. I definitely understand that. And there are children all over the world. So do these things what I have told you to do. They do become hyper and all that. But somehow or the other, you ask your own divine. The divine will give you a proper answer for this. I'm proud of you. You look awesome. Very good. Now, how do I get my kids to improve their concentration studies? You know, for children, actually, I don't know if they will do, but for concentration, if you just do concentrate over here on the third eye and do Om Dhyan. Om Dhyan is very good for concentration. So if they do Om, ideally 21 times, but I don't know how old your child is. So he may not be able to do it for 21 times, or even if, as long as they can. Let them do as long as they can. If they are agreeable to it. But this is very good for concentration, for studies. And not just now, for all their lives. My child is super talented. my boys are crazy playing PlayStation. Yeah, I mean, I know screen time is something which is... thank God we didn't have it when we were growing up. How, man, share it with the... What do you mean? What is how, ma'am? What is that I spoke of? I don't know. What do you want me to share, Preeti? Please tell me clearly what do you want me to share. I don't know, Sheila, how do you take a class in Bhagavad Gita? But I honestly suggest there is a lot of things online if you want. You don't have to take a class for Bhagavad Gita. This is what I feel. There are lots of people who talk about Bhagavad Gita, the Vedanta, the trees, so much. Bhagavad Gita is like so many millions of years old, the holy book that we have. Lot of people read it, lot of people can speak the Sanskrit shlokas just like this. But I would like to see the change in the person. Then it is important to read that particular, whatever, whichever holy book. The important thing is that you have to change. The shift has to show. Not by just reading the books and knowing it here, no. The shift has to be in the heart. All knowledge which is just here, it's of no use. It's just knowledge. It's going to stay here. It's of no use if you don't shift from inside. So learning Bhagavad Gita and all these things that you have, there are a lot of people who talk about the Gita. See if you can apply it and change within. In this scenario, they'll lose temper and do so, how to calm them down. Yeah, this is going to be their little bit of losing temper. You will lose, the children will lose. Wo to hona hi hai, because it is very frustrating to keep them tied down for so long. You'll have to find out a way around it, how to do it. Very difficult to handle 5 year, 3 year, yes. I understand all this, but now you have to find out the way to get out of it. No, do we have a choice? When we don't have a choice, what do we have to do? You have to find out a way around it. So you will have to find out a way around it. You will find it also, because you're not the only mom who's got tiny children. There may be so many moms all over the world with tiny children who don't concentrate, who don't listen, who get angry. All these things are common, no? For everyone. So each one is finding out some way or the other of handling that handling the children. So you'll have to find out your own way. You know your children best and you know what will work with them and what not. How to improve their concentration? I just said that you can do the Om chanting. What is your message to stay sane? Where is that gone? Where is that message gone? How to improve concentration? Can you share the activities or the timetable you follow? I don't have children so small. My daughter-in-law, but see, each activity and timetable has to be according to the choice of your child and the age group of your child. Somebody else's timetable will not suit your child. So don't copy somebody else's stuff. Do some manner on your own. Everybody wants everything instant. No, you can't get things instantly like that. You can't just tell, okay, child shut up and the child shuts up. No, it doesn't happen that way. Where can I get complete course on Bhagavad Gita? The same question again. We need to take, yes, you need to take it all upon yourselves. I'm glad to see your video. My child loves simply the home food. Very good. French fries, pani puri once in a while. Once in a while, of course, you have to indulge in it. But not like a daily thing, which most people are only living on outside food all the time. Okay, so I think we have spoken for about 45 minutes. Please start doing the meditation. Thank you for Hamdil Dijikesanam. Nice to see you. Okay, now we've got the same repeat kind of of questions. So guys, I will take your leave now and thank you very much again for this Unimom, for calling me on this platform and talking to you all. I wish you all the best and luck with you and your children. Don't forget the tips I've told you. It's not just like a one-time talk over here and it's all over and gone out of your mind once the video stops. But do follow it and do subscribe for the channel. It'll really help you. Honestly, it'll help you. A lot of things which you can do with your daily life stuff. It's a lot of things are there on there. I've got almost 500 videos on that. So they will really help you. So just check that out and subscribe for the video and start following certain things which I have told you all. Okay. Namaste. Thank you very much. Bye. See you.